Hello everyone, Kumo here, and welcome to episode 6 of my beginner guide. And today, and sorry, by the way, sorry for the delay, but today we are going to Act 3. And hopefully we're actually gonna get longer than Act 3. But first, we are going to deal with someone. Let's give a sec here. Yes, we have deal with Creighton. Actually, we're not gonna deal with him, we're actually gonna help him. In this particular build, I want to help Oak, because I want the life, and I'm going to explain a little bit better when I reach him. So, just following the stone road here. Actually, I lost stone road. Where is stone road? Yeah, let's get some experience, by the way. I see it is here. Oh, there up it is. Let's follow the stone road here. It's barely visible, but it is there. Going the wrong way. Ah, here we go. So let's go to wetlands and let's find Oak. So I'm cutting here, so you don't have to see me walking the slow way to get to Oak. And finally, I found it. Just walk right past it. But here we have Oak. And if you want to kill him, we will actually get rewarded by a passive skill point. But if you want to help him, you can see he gives us 40 to maximum life. And 40 to maximum life is really, really good. So I am going to help him. Now we get permanently 40 increased life. So now we actually get the last pieces we need to progress Act 2. We actually have the apex now, and that's exactly what we need. And I actually ending up finding the waypoint when I was looking for Orc. Well. So, to open this route here, you know we have been in Chamber of Sin up here. And we went to the Weaver's Chamber here in the Western Forest and killed that giant spider. And that's where we get this one, Malagar Spike and the Belful Gem. And when you click on these three, they disappear and the way to the Vault Ruins is open for you. This area is quite big, so I'm going to cut here to show what to do next. And here we are finding the way to next area. Just press on the engine seal and everything goes, well, tonight. So there is where you actually release the Vol Oversoul, which are the final boss of Act 2. And it's the one I'm going to hunt for now. So let's go into the Northern Forest. This forest is actually a quite good farming place. Just like a regular, it's easy to go here. Let's just say like that. It's a little bit similar to like the ledge for some reason. It's actually quite similar. It's actually a good farming place. And this is a unique enemy freeze. I actually make you bleed. It's not a big deal whatsoever. But I actually find that a new, maybe potential new armor I can use. So we're gonna take a look at that armor. And let's see if this is good. It's good. Gives better armor, actually. Better armor is actually good enough for me to use that. It doesn't give any life, but it gives better armor. So I'm using that instead. And I don't think I picked up some other stuff. Why I pick up this one, I have no idea. But let's take a look at these goggles here. They maybe are better than the one I'm currently using. That is actually quite good. Look at that attack speed. And also there's some nice with some extra dexterity and some life. Definitely upgrade. They're actually giving more attacks than these ones. This one have resistance, but well, I don't care that much about resistance right now. And I actually got a flask upgrade as well. Things are going forward. So let me make my way through this area, and I see you at the entrance to the next area. Have a look at this. I actually find Kadir here. It drops a silver coin. Why, Kadir, can you not accept silver coins? I can't buy that. But your Perandus friends back here. Well, why can you not, Kadir, not like collect your own coins? They are like right next to you. But alright. Let's see if actually we get enough coins from here. And actually, I don't think I'm actually that into buying that ring when I think about it. Maybe I'm saving these Brandos coins. I want to continue. I need to get back to town soon. It's starting to get, I'm getting a little bit piled up here. I gotta throw that away. I don't know why I have that. So fire, ancestral wood, ancestral protector. I don't care what that either. I can always buy a new one. There is some useful stuff there. Well, again, I think I don't gonna get his item, so I gotta move forward. And here we have reached the caverns, the next area. Now we are getting somewhere. Now we're gonna make our way to the ancient pyramid. This area is actually quite big, and by the way, I actually forgot I have leveled. So let's continue this way, and actually I think I'm gonna go for some damage now, because my damage started to lacking, so it's time to do some more spanking. I'm gonna go for some amber dexterity. So let's make our way here. I'm gonna start looking for a new weapon to upgrade. Should be some good base type weapon to upgrade soon. So I'm gonna see if I can take have an eye look for that actually. It would be really helpful because, as I said, my damage is starting to lack a little bit now. I want to 2 or 1 shot things, not 3 shot things. So as soon as time to upgrade one weapon, and here are some warbands helping me. Maybe they are dropping something interesting. That is interesting. Well, it's time for me actually to go back to town, so let's take a look at this basket rapier here and see if it's any good. Pretty good attack speed, pretty good elemental damage, but I want physical damage on it, so not good enough. But I know one thing I'm gonna do now, and that is get back to town and sell all my wonderful stuff here and get a load of currency, which I desperately need. And actually, do I have that one? I have that one. Anyway, let's sell some crap to you. Oh man, I forgot something. I forgot to identify these ones. Give me better rewards if you are identifying them. I'm gonna sell my old weapon. We're getting some chromatics, which we're going to need in the end. And again, stash tab 8 is this character's stash tab. Only currency from this place, no other way. So let's do like this. Other stash tab all for my other characters in this league. And we actually add another level, so let's get more dual damage and attack speed. And let's go to caverns. Let's take that boarding axe again. And I think I'm gonna cut here again, because this is going to again be a little bit tough. It will be boring for you to see me go slowly through this area, but I'll show if I find something interesting, or if something interesting happens, I promise. And now we're getting somewhere. Here we have the waypoint. And now I seriously need to upgrade my weapon. They are really falling behind. And I actually found this basket rapier here. So let's see if I can use that instead of my axe. So let's do the recipe. We have a rustic stash there. So can we craft this rustic stash some way? Let's use a chance, or maybe it will become a yellow or something. It didn't become a yellow, and it's not better than the one I currently have. So I'm going to use the recipe on it. And I just forgot one of the ingredients. I need a blacksmith whipstone for that. So I'm gonna speak to you, Groost. And that is a lot better than the one I currently have, or is it? Is as fast it do? Well, it is actually a little bit better. The maximum damage is better, so I actually gonna use that anyway. Actually, do you selling something interesting? You're selling chromatic or something? Actually, why didn't I bought this axe or whatever? Broadsword, they're a little bit slow. I think I'm gonna wait for the next level before that. This weapon have a lot of damage, so maybe I should have a broad axe as well. And not use this one. I was thinking. Should I use this one? But it is slow, I don't like that. But if I can one hit things by just using one attack, then maybe I'm worth it. And remember, I haven't taken any sword notes, so using sword or axes doesn't matter whatsoever. I can even use daggers if I feel for it. So let's go to Yina here and see if I can buy another rustic stash. And that rustic stash I want to upgrade. Have you look at that? Actually, that one is a lot better than the one I have. Actually an upgrade, a crafted upgrade. So let's use that instead. And let's use my old one under with the recipe. Oh yeah, now we're getting somewhere. That's a lot of damage right there. So let's upgrade all of my weapon I'm currently using to these two weapons. They're doing more damage. And let's crawl and see if we can get attack speed or flat physical damage. That would be amazing. We get strain, that's a little bit of damage. We get stun threshold, which are not that much damage, but I don't know who bloody cares. I use these things anyway, and now I can't use fast attack with whirling blades anymore. But I can still have it there, and I'm going to have this anyway. So let's sell the things I have right now, getting some currency back, and let's get back to our adventure. And I'm going to make my way up to the apex of this place, and by the way, my damage right now is 613, which should be enough to one or two hit pretty much most normal enemies, so it should be good. Anyway, I see you at the top of this pyramid. I find another Kadir here. Can this one be good? Well, why not? Why not? Oh, I wish I had that portal effect. That portal effect is amazing. So let's take a look at this Yule here. Ooh, have a look at that. That's actually quite good. That is a quite good Yule indeed. I don't have a Yule socket right now, but I'm definitely going to take this one because... Oh, wrong button. This one is actually good. Look at that. Increase attack speed when dual wielding, increase melee damage, and some resistance. What more can you ask for? And by the way, I got the levels, so actually let's take this strength note here to get the Yule socket here. But anyway, let's continue our journey to the apex of this pyramid. And here we have found the apex, so now it's time to fight the boss. And I like the music in this place, so I'm actually gonna turn it on. I really like this music. Well, this game have amazing music. It have nothing to do with the guide, I just like it. So, let's see what Val can do, and I can see if I can explain the battle. Because Val is a pretty mechanical battle, and well, it's not that difficult, actually. You have like two really dangerous things you need to watch out for, and I'm gonna see if you can do all of them. This is summing. Well, you just summing some ads, nothing particular, and then you just go down and like hides as the coward he is and hope his small insignificant minions. That's what he's doing right there. Do not get hit by that, just go behind and do something like that. Sometimes he just feels for doing his like cowardly attack again. Hope his minion do his dirty work for him, but they are just completely worthless. So that is his ice attack. It does no damage, but it can slow it down, and that means you can't get hit by anything. There is the hard melee attack again. It do split fire and elemental. There, what they're doing right now is the famous laser, and that it is, for me at least, the most dangerous attack he's doing because it's hard to evade. Especially if you're fighting him on a high level map, be careful with that laser. Other things is easy to evade, but when he's doing the laser, he has so little time to react. That, you don't have to be one hit by that, but it will do a lot of damage. And look at that, we find maybe a good Yule. And another flask. Let's take a look what we find. Actually, I found this mace before. Let's see if it actually are good. That actually quite nice, if I can be honest. Well, going to make my attack even slower. But my attack's going to hit really hard. But I can't use it yet, but that's a quite good mace. I could use that instead of a sword here. Or maybe the axe. Well, do as much damage as the axe. I'll get a bit more damage than the axe. And actually get this flask here. I think I'm gonna use this flask later. When I can. And we have another amulet here. Give us spell damage. I don't think I am a spellcaster, so I have no use for that. And now we are in one of my favorite areas in the entire game. I'm gonna slow the sound a little bit. This is my favorite area in the entire game. Do you wanna know why? Because I have a name for this area. You know this is called City of Sun? For me, it's called City of Farm, because I absolutely love to farm this place. They are easy enemy. It's really quick to farm, and well, it's pretty much no like chance that you actually get lost here and not find where you need to go. Just going straight forward. So for me, this is one of my favorite farming places in the entire game. I used to spend hours upon hours in farming this place, and I can farm this place right now. It's right my level, so I can farm it. So if you want to farm a little bit in early game, as we are still pretty early game still, this is a good place to farm in. If you want to have a little bit of well, be a little bit more powerful in for what you're gonna fight. And here we have a war sword. I take that win. I don't think I'm gonna do that base type, because it's a slow base type, and I'm a big fan of the faster swords and faster access. But well, take it with me. Yeah, we have a chromatic item. Well, just kill these black holes here. I almost forget I need to mention that. Just kill the black holes and talk to Clarissa, and she will be waiting for us in the town here. A basket rapier right there. And actually, in this act, we're going to receive one of our big damage things, which are the hatred aura. And I freaking love the hatred aura. But I'm going to talk a little bit more about that when we get in there. So let's get to Sun encampment. I'm not gonna farm this place today, but I could do it to get one or two level. It's not necessary whatsoever, you can just continue on. But actually in Merciless, I just love to spend some time there just gearing up a little bit and well, have some fun and make some easy level. And maybe you find something good. I'm just gonna go down here, and by the way, I'm going to talk about the ascendancy, because it's starting to get closer to when we are going to ascend for the first time. And I have already done all of the trials on another character, but of course I'm going to show where each and every one of the location are for ascendancy, if you don't know it already, for this on this character. But I'm not going to do it today. But first we are going to sell some stuff. I don't know why I picked that up, so I'm gonna sell that. It's not even worth it. Oh, actually, yes, I'm gonna sell it anyway, because I want to have at least one scroll fragment. Scroll fragments are like the most worthless piece of crap you can have in currency in this game. And maybe some of you want to see my currency on my other stash tabs, but I don't want to show it, because it's pathetic. It is really, really pathetic. But I'm not gonna talk too much about this, so... And they're gonna stop wasting time and actually get to the crematorium, which are the first area you should go to. And it will be, I think it is there. I'm going to show it when I get there. So let's ascend to the sun, well, the slums. Like the poor people that live here, they can't have a good life. Like just watching it. It's like they are in a big prison. They just have walls everywhere. Man, it's depressing. I like the art style, but all of this torture instrument everywhere. Oh, the government on this place can't be in particular nice. I don't know. I don't even really like the look of it. I'm not gonna talk about fictional politics right now, so let I see you when I reach the crematorium. And now we have reached the crematorium. And I actually picked up a level, so let's see how much damage we're gonna get by using my new Yule right there. So let's take this Yule token here. And let's also put this one in here. Right now I'm doing 617 damage. And with this one, I'm doing 666 damage, the number of the beast. Alright, a little bit too dramatic right there. Actually, find this armor as well, so let's see if they are any good. They actually are quite good. They can give me some good protection. They're actually giving me better protection than the one I have. Giving less armor, but giving evasion rating. a little bit on life and better fire resistance. This one, dude. I'm gonna use that instead. I mean, when I now are on exactly 800 life, which are quite good. So now we are going to see if we can find Pyatea and what she are doing in this dark, forbidden place. That was also too dramatic. Oh, I should stop saying things like that. Oh, right. I shouldn't have killed him before he jumped in there. Oh, and by the way, before I forgot, before I cut here to I find Pyatea, I'm going to show something. I've actually found, this essence right here. So, this war sword here. Maybe it would be better. That's one physical damage. Well, it may have big chance not to be good. So, oh, look at that. Some good currency. So let's actually use this essence. I think. Let's see what's happening at least. I don't know. I don't think. No, that's not better. Too little damage for my taste. Well, I see you when I find Pyatea. And look at this, we have found a way to, well, Pyatea. When you find this not at all suspicious, like, pile of corpses, you know you'll find the right way. Jagged foil, that's an upgraded weapon from the one I'm using right now. Ah, I'm not gonna take that, I have full inventory. Well, when you find this pile of corpses here and the blood here, you have found Pyatea, because where there are corpses and blood, you find Pyatea. And by the way, I should mention, Pyatea doing lightning damage here, and a lot of fire damage in this area, so having good fire damage and lightning resist are a really recommendation when you're going to this area. Yes, forgot to mention it before. And when you took down Pyatea's health to halfway, she will just run away. And here we have Tallman, which was, well, Clarissa's boyfriend, rest in peace Tallman, which now are dead, and he drops the Tallman's bracelet, which you need to deliver to Clarissa, so she has something to mourn about. I feel sad for you, Clarissa. And we get the sewer keys, now we can unlock the next area, but before that, let's sell some crap. It's always good with some more currency. Let's identify this dagger here. You never know if it is better, and actually we can use some new flasks. So let's use that and destroy the old one. And yeah, whatever. Actually, before I went go away, let's put our currency here in safekeeping. That one. Actually, let's identify this one. Grants low level recovery to minions. I don't care the slightest about that, so let's destroy that and keep going. Actually, let's put that one there. And by the way, now we're gonna find the entrance to the sewers. And I'm gonna go to and actually find a second waypoint. Then I think I'm gonna call it for today, because I don't want this episode to be too long, because it takes 100 years to upload them. But first we are going to find this one, and I need to be a little bit quick when I'm making this episode, so I'm really sorry I've taken this long. I'm sorry to everyone that's following this guide. Well, a lot of things to film, so little time to do it. But now we are in the sewers. Isn't this not a pretty place? No, it's not. It's a horrible place. I wonder what all of these green things are that growing on the ground. And something tells me I actually don't want to know it. Maybe these are like Pyatea's secret weed garden or something like that. No, I'm just kidding. It's not. Kill that ghost. Actually, how do you kill a ghost? Oh, well, I shouldn't talk about too much about that. And here we have some essence enemies, so essence of fear. Not gonna hit by that, because I can just evade it. That's one thing I love with Whirling Blades, when you see something like preparing a hard attack like that, just use Whirling Blade to get out of it. So let's take this strongbox here as well. Ancient sword. Now we're getting to some pretty powerful stuff. I want to use oh, now I don't remember the name of that sword, but it's a level 30 sword, which I one of my favorite to use in low level. Elegant sword it was. Elegant foiled or elegant like sword. That's one of my favorite because it's a fast weapon, and I like the fast weapons because I like being fast. Let's see if we can. You have a unique enemy for this area, and it actually jumps on you. It's actually a really annoying enemy, and this hurts actually a little bit. And we got a level. Look at this. That is one of my favorite shrines in the entire game. That is an acceleration shrine. We make a... Why do it dropping? Wait a second. Maybe it isn't a glitch. Maybe it because... Shrines drop 2 currency drop 7 currency items when used, and then we got a castle. That explains everything. So just forget what I said before, it is no glitch. I just have some League Stones activated without even knowing it. And by the way, here we find one of the 3 platinum bursts, so I can't pronounce that. Which we need for doing a side quest, which will grant us a passive skill point. And I love passive skill points. Let's see if we can hurry up now and get to next area. So, next area should be in this way here. And it is. The sewers, warehouse sewers. And I'm gonna find the waypoint here, and I think I'm gonna continue from that. And one of my leak stones are too low level, so let's throw it away because we're never gonna use it anymore. And let's use another leak stone. And a key leak stone. So now we're going to fight a ton of like random exiles that do a lot of damage and drops a lot of loots. Let's get rid of you. Never found the next platinum burst. I don't know how to say that. I dropped an arming axe there. That's a quite good weapon actually. That's a quite good base type. Well, there's so many good base types that are dropping right now, so I don't know what to choose anymore. But I think I'm gonna go for the higher ones that drops with lava out. I think it likes 28. My one of my favorite base type will start to drop, and we are getting there. And now we get another point here, so I'm gonna actually no. Some double damage and attack speed. I'm gonna go for dexterity, and then I'm gonna go for at least the first one here. To help out our mana. And now we have found the undying blockade, and to destroy that we're going to do a little bit of a quest chain, but that will be in the next episode. But before that we have I can't say that, so let's just deliver into Hagen here. We need to deliver one more and we get our awesome reward. And I have picked up something weird, so... Actually... That's not that bad. I think I'm gonna replace this helmet with this one. Let's sell that one. I think I'm gonna upgrade that axe as well, maybe. And I think I'm wasting a little bit of currency. Let's take this blacksmith webstone, and let's actually buy a new belt and use our newly found, or actually just buy a blue one and just sell that and get a better weapon. I love this recipe. It's so simple. Look at that. That's a quite good weapon. So I want that, and let's see if we can actually get some attack speed on this one. And we need an augmentation orb and cold resistance. Why not? I use that instead of this one, because that's a lot more powerful. It's actually a little bit slower, but do a lot more damage. So let's sell that one, and actually we should upgrade this one as well. So why not doing that? If I can, I can't. Think, was it not a recipe with this one? I don't remember. Anyway, I thank you for watching, and... Sorry for the delay, and I'm gonna be a little bit faster next episode. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and see you guys next time.